And fear is this energy that prevents the joy to flow through us, the love to flow through us, right? That is such a big thing. Well, we don't go there. Yeah. No. The same thing with forgiveness. Imagine how you would feel if you have forgiven your mother, your father, your bosses, and the people that bullied you, and the man that hurt you, and the women that hurt you, and all that, and you have just let it free. You understood, yeah, that everyone has to play a role in your life, yeah, and otherwise the movie cannot happen, yeah, right? So there is people that we have to hurt, and there is people that have to hurt us, yeah. But at the end of the day, yeah, we know that it is a dream, yeah. And when you die, you will make a quantum jump. You know, it's not a little thing. It is not like door open, boom, come in another world, and then no. It is a complete change of dimension. Yeah. You cannot make this bridge to it. You understand? It's not something that you can grab. Yeah. It is a complete jump into another world, into another reality where everything becomes very different in the way you understand. And you see yourself, and you see all the whys and all the reasons why that lifetime happened in the way it happened, yeah. So that you may learn from it, no? Yes. So because there is a deep wish in us that we want to succeed, yeah. And the success we understand partly it is in the world because we have a position in the world, yeah. But the success in the world doesn't mean that you become just rich or powerful or important or famous. The success is that whatever situation you're into it, you are in perfect peace with it. That would be the success, yeah. If it is rich, then be happy rich, very rare. If it is poor, be happy poor, which is much more the case with people. Yeah. Yeah, you will find much more happy poor people than happy rich ones. That is for certain. Yeah. No. So whatever would be your situation, in the moment you find complete agreement with it, complete peace, you say, yes, it is fine. It is absolutely fine now. There is nothing missing. Yeah. Right. This is what we want to reach right before we leave from this world. That we can say we lived our life to our best capacity, yeah, to our best way, the best we know how we should live it. Right? Yes. So everything in us that says, okay, I try, stop it. Yeah, don't try, you know, don't try anymore. See whatever you want to engage in continuous practicing, you need to understand that it will come with difficulties. Yeah. It will never, ever be just easy. There can be easy moments, but basically it is not easy. It will be a battle, yeah? And you have to come with all the courage. You have to come with an unshakable willpower, yeah? Because you want to reach it, right? And there is nothing that stops you. There is nothing. No, nothing from outside will stop you. You stop it or you don't stop it. That is the point. Right? Yeah. There is nobody that says, yeah, yeah, keep on smoking, yeah, that is good for you. Yeah. And even if there is someone, who cares? Yeah, who cares? You understand it, and so you say, no, it's finished. It's finished for me. Yeah, right? And one, those of you who made it, they understand that, and you should apply this, what you did, leaving the smoke, yeah, you should apply it on everything in your life, yeah? On absolutely everything, right? And that will make you to be very happy, yeah, because you did it, you did it. Yeah? But of course, look, the enemy is the ego, because it will lose its power, it will lose its identity, it will have to go. Yeah. And this is a very, very difficult thing. Yeah. Because it will not be like this, that your real self is like already visible to you in that sense. No. Yeah. The veil, all the veils of the ego illusions have to fall, have to be removed. And this point where it is between removed and the new one is coming is a very, very heavy point. Yeah. It's a point where you feel, I can lose my mind. Yeah. Where the fear of craziness comes to you very, very strong. Yeah. Because all the concepts, yeah, all this that speaks all the time to yourself and says you are like this, like this, like this, like this, like this, yeah, that breaks. Yeah. Right? What you do is that you will not say, I'm that, but you will say, I'm not that. Yeah. Yeah, this is not. No. And in the Sufi tradition, we have this phrase of La ilaha illallah. And in the beginning, when we do something, yeah, we use La ilaha. Yeah. We don't use La ilaha illallah because the illallah must come up by itself. Yeah. So illallah means nothing except the divine, right? And before we are ready for that, the other, the La ilaha, has to go. Yeah. La ilaha means there is no idol, there is no opinion, there is no complain, there is no remorse, there is no fear, there is no pride, there is no envy. Yeah. Okay. And it is just thing. So what was the thing? First thing when we to support our battle is the thankfulness. No, we say it thousands of times, doesn't matter. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Thankfulness. Yes. Yeah. That's the thing. Okay. Yeah. One mantra you will be given in hell. Yeah. If you enter hell. Yeah. And that is thank you. That's the mantra in the hell. Yeah. You will say thank you. You are in hell. And you will say thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Yeah. Watch out. You will see. If you come to hell. Yeah. So we live all the time in the on-off. That means we live in the hell and we live in the heaven, yeah, at the same time. Yeah. This is the paradox in which we are living. Yeah. That's why you see, that's why you can still live with yourself. Yeah. Because there is something on. Yeah. There is a heart in everyone. There is a soul in everyone. There is a goodness in everyone. Yeah. But there is also the other. Yeah. Right. Yes. Yeah. So, and this La ilaha, that is this other, yeah, that talks all the time to you and that says, very mean again with you. They did. Look, you are so kind, you're so friendly, and look what comes back. And you try to be kind with everyone, and look at those, you know, yeah, and they're so. Right, isn't it? No? Yeah. And it's not fair, it's not fair. And then look, those, oh my goodness, you know, yeah. you try not to waste water, and then you see God knows people, you know, and you say, what God is it? Yeah, we cannot make it with those, yeah, and so on, no? Yeah. So all that you take it back. Yeah. There's nothing to say to us, for us to mention. Yeah. Now when they asked Ramana Maharshi, I love it, they asked him, oh Ramana, what about the others? Yeah. And he said, there is no other. Yeah. There is no other. Yeah. It's illallah. Yeah. There is, at the end you will find it. Yeah, you will find it. No. And the word trauma, yeah, that is like the word of the last decade now is the trauma, right? This is the everyone has to have trauma, and you have trauma, and trauma is basically your profession, no? Yeah. So everyone is a traumatologist, no? Yeah, for himself, right? You have a lot to do with your traumas. And those of you who speak German, yeah, they know that the word trauma contains the word Traum, which means dream, no? So the trauma, yeah, leaves you to the dream, okay? Yeah. And the trauma is also connected to the word drama, yeah? They're all connected, yeah? Right? So when you're in the trauma and you cannot see it, you cannot see the illusion of it, you cannot free yourself from this, yeah, from this chain, from this cage, no? Then you have a drama, yeah? Then you run into the drama, and the drama is this flat dimension of life that you can't really see what's going on. Yeah. You feel disconnected. Yeah. You're not connected. You feel disconnected no matter what you believe. Yeah. Right. There is a disconnection, a permanent disconnection. Yeah. And that has to do with the drama. Yeah. So the drama, we need one day to go into the observant, that is the vertical force that allows us, yeah, to see.